Hello, traders. Today is the 16th of June 2010, and this video is about Elliott Wave. Okay, and if you watch my previous video, we know that the first wave is the one that will come out of the consolidation zone, boom, out of the box. Okay, as you can see here, there was a trend, okay, a downtrend on this 4 hour chart of the Euro USD. A downtrend, nice downtrend, okay. And then the price was bumping up and down between these two red horizontal line here, which we call this the consolidation period, or a quiet market, or a low volatility period, or equal lows and equal high levels. Okay, when the price consolidating, you will have equal lows and equal highs. Okay, horizontal line, the price squeeze between two horizontal line. That's how you know that the market is pausing, or the market is relaxing. Okay, and then the first wave will come out of the box, out of the consolidation zone, and boom, this white big bullish candle here, a mother of all bullish candle, is here, boom, out. But because the second wave shouldn't retrace 100% back, it should be the second wave is the one that will pull back, okay, to retest our previous resistance level of the consolidation area and then come back up, okay. But this candle here, this white tall candle here, if you follow my cursor here, has been completely cancelled by this one here in order to retest this. We do not want that, okay. So this one, as we count it first wave, we will have to count it again because it has been completely canceled. It shouldn't be completely canceled, okay? The first wave shouldn't be completely canceled by the second wave, okay? So this is no more the first wave. And then we start counting again, and then there was a nice movement again from this level again all the way up here. Now this is the first wave, okay? And then you retrace back. You see, it didn't cancel, it didn't retrace back all the way to cancel the first wave, okay. It didn't cancel. The second wave is from here down to here, okay. It shouldn't come all the way down here and cancel the first wave. Very important. So now, because this one has canceled this one here, so this is no more the first wave here, so we start counting again, and then it went all the way up here, okay. That's our first wave now, and we will see whether the first wave remain intact. Yes, it remained intact because the second wave didn't cancel it completely. It raced back here, and then boom, the third wave traders, okay, the TST W24 trading system will consistently give you a triple green signal right here. And then if you understand also Elliott wave a little bit, but you do not have to understand the Elliott wave before you can use the TST W24 trading system, you just take the triple green signal, okay, because you know what is the triple green signal, and boom, this is the third wave here. Okay, and then this is a fourth wave here, okay, and then the fifth wave here. End of Elliott wave cycle. You must sell in this zone here, waiting for your A, okay. You will have a A, B, okay, C, okay, correction, okay, ABC correction, not ABCD, but ABC correction, okay. You pull back, come back a little bit up, couldn't reach no more this high here. Okay, the beauty, how do you know the ABC pattern? You pull back first, okay, try to go back up, but will fail to reach this high here, okay. In most cases you will fail to reach this, the previous high here, okay, and then you will turn around, okay. So A, B, okay, and then C, and then can collapse, come back all the way down, okay. This is what we're talking about, okay, the Elliott wave pattern, how you can recognize this pattern in all time frame. But this is on 4 hours anyway. But not only that, if you switch back to the daily chart, okay, you will see that we are in a kind of resistance zone there. I'll switch back to my favorite 1440 minutes, okay, 24 times 60, okay, my favorite intraday daily chart, okay, not the historical one. You will see that we are near this Fibonacci retracement, the 61.8 Fibonacci retracement. You see, that's where we are now, the Fibonacci retracement 61.8. you see, so you have a lot of green signal to try this high probability trade. If you are taking a high probability trade, it does not mean that it is going to work by all means, okay? So if the price is changing direction again, just come out, okay? Because the price is number one indicator, but all the indications are showing us that we must take this trend, okay, to the downside, okay? We are near 61.8 on the daily chart. This is a resistance zone. Also, you see the price is a resistance zone here. Yes, you see. So if I draw, I don't want to draw another horizontal line though there, but just follow my cursor. You see, this is a resistance zone. Also, all this wick here, the antenna, okay, and then the price touches here. You see all this here on the daily chart. So you also know that on the daily chart we have a kind of resistance there, okay, and near the 61.8 Fibonacci retracement level, okay. If you do not know about the Fibonacci retracement level, don't worry about it. You can also go on Google and read about it, but it's not big deal. The price will come down. This is from this level here all the way down here, okay. From this level here, the price went all the way down, and then people take profit. It come back all the way. They take two-third of the profit, okay. And it come back, it reaches this 61.8 level, okay, two-thirds of the profit they take, and then we are expecting the price to pull back down, okay. Usually, I don't want to talk about the Fibonacci extension now because this is not the point of this video. But if you want to know also about the Fibonacci extension, you can read about it also, okay. But then I'm switching back again to my lovely 4 hours chart for you, so you see the picture here, okay. We count the wave, and also on the 4 hour chart we got this wave 1, 2. Okay, let me do it properly for you so you can see my cursor here, because this one has been canceled as I said before. And now we count from here 1, okay, 2 here, okay, 3, okay, here, 4, okay, 5. The Elliott wave cycle is completed, okay. You see, and you sell. Why do you sell? Because it's a high probability, okay. It's a pattern in the market, it's a stable data usually with a high probability, okay. That's why you take the high probability trade. So you see that if you concentrate only on a high probability trade, you'll be rewarded. Like here, if you take this triple green signal given by the TSC W24, you'll be nicely, because the triple green, you'll be nicely in profit, because the triple green signal given by the TSC W24 trading system is a high probability trade, okay. So you are following the trend and you receive a triple green signal originated from a key support level, okay? Because this resistance level that was on this consolidation area has become a support level as the price break out and pull back and retest nicely. And after this candle, you know that this is now a support zone, okay? So the origin of this uptrend movement is good. There is a foundation. This one talking about your trend must originate, okay, from the, I mean the uptrend must originate from a support level, a key support level, okay. So when you see uptrend developing, try to see where this is starting from, where this uptrend is coming from, okay. Is it coming from a valid support level, okay? If it's coming from a valid support level and then you receive a triple green signal, then you just say to yourself, thank you, okay? You just say to it, thank you, and then you take it, okay? But if it's not coming from a reliable, a key support level from the higher time frame, you need to trade carefully if you want to take it, okay? Same thing, the downtrend must originate from a key resistance level also, okay? So when you see a downtrend, you have to ask yourself, where is this downtrend coming from, okay? So you locate first which resistance level has cause this downtrend, okay? And if it's a valid resistance level and you receive a triple red signal, you take it. Very important, okay? As always, you are day trading, you start from the higher time frame and then you switch back to the lower time frame, okay? Your decision are made from the higher time frame, but your entry goes to the lower time frame, okay? So now I'm going to switch back to 5 minutes so you can see what the people on the 5 minutes also will see. So because we know now what is happening on the lower and the higher time frame, because the higher time frame commands, okay, the higher time frame commands the lower time frame, okay. So you see now, this is what the people on the 5 minute chart was seeing, okay. They for right here, okay. If I draw my the trend line is broken, you see this trend line now is broken. Since yesterday night I did a video and I was telling you about this Euro USD that it will come down, About the resistance, we were waiting for the euro to touch. The euro couldn't even touch it, which is 1.2378. It went all the way to 1.2354. Okay, but the people who sold it in the night have to take their profit, because this morning, even though we knew since yesterday that we should sell the euro USD, as you can see, okay, this is yesterday night, the price went down nicely all night here. Okay, from 1.2348 yesterday night. Okay, it went down all night long. Okay. But if you didn't close your position before these people coming in this morning around 7 o'clock, people, okay, 7 o'clock London time, they come back and they push the price back again above where it start from. So if your stop are not strong, they will take you out and only to turn around again and come back down. Okay, so this is about the Elliott wave pattern. Sorry about this. Okay, I'm coming to the end of my 10 minute review too, and I hope you learn something from this video. Until next time, enjoy yourself and be very happy. Thank you.